Hello iOS junkies, in this tutorial we will be learning about universal applications. How can we make a single application design to be presented different in different devices or in different orientation, that is portrait or landscape. And result of this tutorial will be something like this. In portrait mode, you will see the login form as username, then text field, then password, then text field, login and sign up. Something very sequential, or you can say it is in portrait mode as well. Alignment of all the UI element is in sequential order. And when I switch it to the horizontal mode, or you can say the landscape mode, you can see how the spacing and how the position of the UI element changes. The buttons which are used to be below the username and password are moved to the very right, and now we can log in and sign up from here. So stay tuned with me, the Swift Girl, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe the channel. So let's start. Firstly, create a new Xcode project by clicking on it. Click on single view application. Click next. Name it something. For example, we are preparing universal app, so I'm giving it name universal app demo. Okay, make sure the selected language is Swift. Click on next. Choose a proper location where you want to save your project and then click create. Firstly, we will move to the main.storyboard. In main.storyboard, in the view controller, as shown in the preview of this project, we are going to develop some kind of a form which will be having two fields, username and password, and two buttons, login and sign. So let's start making the application UI. Okay, so firstly we will have a label. So in Xcode 10, here is our object library located at very top of the Xcode. Click on this library and type label. From here you can select the label, drag and drop the label and name it. In our case, we are naming it username. Just command D it so that it will be duplicated, and name it as password. Clear. Now we are going to add two text fields in between so that we can add text. So again, go to the object library and type text field. Bring the text field over here like this. Command D it. It will be duplicated like this. Okay. Now what we will do, we will give it a UI, a background color. So for the background color, we will go here on the background settings and select a custom color. Okay. Now we will add two buttons over here. So again, go to the object library and type buttons, double click on it and just add button over here, name it login, command D it to duplicate it, now rename it to the sign. Clear. So we can edit the text, increase the font size of it. We are going to add another label and it will be placed at the very center top of our form. It will be like login here. Make it a bold. To make it bold, we will go to the style and make it bold. Now what we want that our layout in the portrait mode should look like this, and in landscape it should look differently. So for that feature, we will use this vary portrait property over here, you can see at the bottom. So to set the constraint, we will click first on the vary portrait. We will be varying for both height and width, and then click over here And now we are going to just add auto layout constraint as normal. So firstly we will add constraints to it, starting from the very top. So we will be making it horizontally in the container and we will give it a top space. Now moving to the next label, we're giving a vertical space from it, and now the left. Done. For it we will be giving top space and the left space, and in this case we have to give it the trailing space also. Clear. Similarly, give top and leading space. For it we will be giving top, leading and trailing space. For the login button we will making it horizontally in the container, and we will be giving it the top space. Similarly, for the sign up we will be making it horizontally in the container, and we will be giving it the top space. So we have applied the auto layout constraints to all the UI elements in this view. After doing all the constraints, we will just click on this done varying button. We will click on this, and you can see we have made all the auto layout constraints for the portrait mode. Now for the landscape mode, we will click on this orientation, the landscape orientation, and you can see our whole UI is disrupted. It is all damaged. So to overcome all this, we will be doing the same auto layout constraint, but firstly we will click on this vary portrait feature, which includes both height and width. Clear. And now one by one we will be making all the auto layout constraint for this horizontal position as well. So after updating the constraints, our view will look like this, and we can simply click on done varying to finish our variation. So now when we switch on the portrait mode, we will see our UI like this, and when we will move to the landscape mode, we will see our UI like this. So let's go and hit run on it so that we can actually see how it works in real machine. So our build is succeeded, and now let's see what is the output of our universal app demo project. So you can see in the portrait mode our form look like the portrait version of our project, and in the horizontal mode we can see our form behaves differently. So this was all about creating the universal apps in Swift in Xcode 10, which is very new, and I am running the project in iPhone XR with iOS 12. So you can see how easy it is to create universal app, which includes creating different design in different orientation or in different iPhones or iPads, same design work differently in different modules. So when I'm switching to the portrait mode, you can see the UI is like this, and when I'm switching it to horizontal mode, it is like this. So I hope things are clear to you. If you have any doubt, any question about the universal app making, you can comment down below and I'll make sure to answer it properly. Thank you and stay tuned with the Swift Girls channel.